MMA fighter and stuff like this, but do you think it's the next fight we can see Jake in with a pure boxer, which is his number one spot, which is boxing rather than an MMA guy coming over, a basketball player or a YouTuber, that his next fight will be a professional boxer?
It depends. It could be. It might not be. I mean, Jake's business model is a little different than everybody else. It would have to be a boxer with the type of, you know, credentials you can bring and warrant the type of show that Jake's putting on. It can't just be a one-sided promotion like it would be with most boxers. And Jake, obviously, he's only 3-0. He's not ready to fight the top guys who could potentially bring, you know, the type of acknowledgement that an event like this would need. So the right step's got to be taken. He's only 3-0. He's only been boxing a year and a half, almost 2 years. So with patience, he will fight a lot of good boxers. But right now, we're just picking out good names, big people, and still people that, you know, the general public feels like this guy's going to beat you. So it's not like we're taking guys who are 100% slam dunks. Like this, the majority of the people, especially in the MMA world, they all feel like Jake's going to knock down. So this is a pretty dangerous fight for a kid who's 3-0.
BJ, obviously we've all seen the right hand.
Yeah.
It's devastating. And we haven't had time to see a whole lot more because, you know, a lot of the fights ended in like first round or something like that. Does Jake have a lot more weapons that we just haven't seen yet? Or are you guys developing other stuff, or is just the right hand's working and going to look like how well you can?
It all works. It all works very well. And if we can just get into that second round or whatever, then you're going to see on Sunday night. Like, this guy, I mean, that's why I'm excited, I think, about this event, because what we see behind closed doors, with top professionals coming in that we spar with hundreds of rounds. I'm not talking about 10, 20, 30. I'm talking hundreds of rounds over the last, you know, 18, 24 months. It all works. And you're going to see that on Sunday. If Tyron gets in the second or third round, you'll see that. You know, he's got a lot of other weapons. People have no idea. And hopefully, you know, Tyron can. And that's why we took Tyron. I'm the one who said, I want to fight Tyron. His manager asked me. They're like, is Jake ready for Tyron? I said, yes, he's ready. And hopefully this guy will take us into a second or third round, because Jake needs to get some rounds. I don't want him just going in there blasting all these guys out. And with all due respect to Gibb and to Nate Robinson and, you know, Ben Askren, those guys were on Jake's level, and honestly, Tyron's not his level either. So you'll see that Sunday.
Jake is still green in the boxing game.
He is.
Is he like a superior talent to most who take the amateur route? Like, are there still mistakes he's making and growing? Or,
I mean, of course he's still making mistakes. He's 3-0, you know. It takes years and years and thousands of hours to perfect your craft. You don't just wake up and you're a seasoned professional boxer. I mean, you got to take your lumps in the gym. You got to take your lumps in training. And Jake's done that. Like, Jake sparred with, you know, world champions. Jake sparred with, you know, top contenders. And, you know, he's taken his lumps, trust me. It's not like he just goes in there and he's baby. He's not. And that's the most misunderstood thing about Jake. People think we go easy on Jake. People think he's soft. He's not soft. And I mean, whoever gets in there with him, it's almost too late by the time you get in there to realize, man, this guy's actually pretty good. And, you know, once you get into the second and third round with Jake, I mean, he's still going at the same pace and going faster and harder and harder. He's like a shark, I'm telling you. I was talking to my dad yesterday. I compare him like a shark. Like, once he gets in the water and he gets in there, he just wants to swim. And then once he tastes a little blood, he's like, he goes crazy. So he's really got that kind of, like, sick, you know, that sick personality where he wants more whenever he gets going, and I like that.
I'll follow up on that question then.